A new feature film, Orca, is being screened here in Washington. It's based on a true story from the memoir penned by ethnomusicologist Louis Chalno. VOA's Caroline Turner has the story.
The title of the film, Orca, translates to listen in the Aka language. The film features British actor Chris Marshall, who plays Larry, a New Jersey ethnomusicologist who returns to Africa against his doctor's orders.
They won't be calling you anything anymore, Larry. Your African days are over.
For how long?
Forever.
I have to get home to Africa.
I am the world expert on Byaka pygmy music.
This music is Beethoven to me.
Larry answers the call of his pygmy friends in the Central Africa Republic. He returns, intent on capturing their music. But the world has changed since he's been gone, and he discovers loggers are tearing apart the quiet African rainforest, threatening the indigenous pygmy lifestyle. He learns the corrupt mayor is scheming to remove the pygmies from their land.
Ah, Monsieur Larry, you are a very good friend of our little brother, almost a pygmy yourself. Mr. Yi, meet Mr. Larry.
And the American who lives with the pygmies, won't he interfere?
Larry's not long for this world, Mr. Yi.
The filmmaker, Lavinia Curie, was attracted to the story of people compromised and taken from their land.
The Byaka are endangered people. Their forest is endangered, there's logging coming from the south. The bushmeat trade has impacted their ability to survive in the forest because the small animals are being hunted out. So they are a people like so many indigenous people that are in danger of perishing. And I think what I wanted to do with the film is to celebrate their way of life, to show what competent ecologists they are. You know, you see in the film that they can hunt, they can hear things that we can't hear.
Larry is intent on capturing the Byaka music, which he finds everywhere.
These are people who danced for the pharaohs. I mean, their music is famous from, you know, the beginning of history, and they're fantastic musicians. Women are really the bosses of the music. They tend to write the songs, and they tend to set the tempo and the subject of the songs. So the music is really an amazing part of their culture and of the film.
Larry is like a fish out of water, and the Byaka have endless fun with him. Curie employed locals and trained them to act.
They were all people from the forest and the village. And the medicine man, Mapumba, is his real name, who plays Sitaka, was really a medicine man. We found him in the forest, living in a hut very much like the one you see him in with his wife in the beginning of the film. And he did have gifts for medicine, was an extraordinary man.
The storyline traces Larry's ultimate quest to capture the music of the legendary Molimo, a musical instrument that imitates the elephant mating call and is used to hunt.
When I first went, I asked the pygmies, I said, do you know the Molimo? And they said, oh no, of course not, that's ancestral. And then little by little, they started talking about it because of course they're not supposed to hunt elephants. It's their protection.
Well, thanks, Caroline.